Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
3A and 4A basketball championships are coming up next here on the Indiana Cable Network. Second session of the day. We've already crowned the 1A and the 2A champion. Tonight we'll go for the 3A and the 4A, starting the first off with the Class 3A Rochester Zebras and the Tigers of Princeton High School. Hello again, fans. Jerry Baker alongside my buddy John Laskowski. Delighted to have you here tonight. John, I'm looking around already. A few minutes before tip-off. Great crowds, two teams, never been here. This has got to be a thrill.
It will be. In fact, Jerry, one team from the north, the Rochester Zebras on the northern part of the state. Princeton, they're on the southern part of the state. They don't know much about each other just from the tape. It's going to be an interesting matchup.
Absolutely. Neither of these teams played a ranked team on their way to this championship game. Let's take a look now at the tournament trail. First off, for the Zebras of Rochester, winners at the Plymouth Sectional. They beat Plymouth for the first time in a century, it seems like. Then they went to the Plymouth Regional, knocked off Griffith and Gary Roosevelt. Then last Saturday, a 7-point win over Delta. Last an average win of 15 points per game. They got a number of players that are really good, but Bruce Grimm is their leader.
Yeah, 6'1" and a senior. In fact, his dad played for Rochester back in the mid-70s. Grimm's a very good shooter at 25 points a ball game. They look for his leadership quite a bit.
Rob Malco's team at 23-3. Let's switch now to Princeton. They are undefeated on the season. Here's their tournament trail. They won their own sectional over Gibson Southern, Boonville, Evansville Memorial. They won the Washington Regional, beating Edgewood and Salem Mid last Saturday in the semi-state of 10-point win over Greensburg. Lads average win almost 15 per game, much like Rochester. They have four players in double figures. Trevor George is one of their main cogs.
He is 6'3" and 16 points, 8 rebounds a ball game. He has a twin brother, Brant, on the team at 6'2". In fact, there's two sets of twins on the Princeton team.
Tom Weeks, the head coach, as we mentioned, Princeton now comes in at 28-0. The opening tip-off is just around the corner. Laz's keys of the games are coming up. Then we'll go for Rochester and Princeton and the 3A championship. We begin this evening's activities here at Conseco Fieldhouse with the 3A championship between Rochester and Princeton. And time for a look at the St. Vincent Sports Performance keys to the game. With those keys, here's John.
For Rochester, the Zebras, they lead with Grimm. He scores 25 a game, as we talked about, and he has got to get the ball and lead this team as a senior. And they need to force some turnovers on the defensive end to get him some easy baskets. The sophomores must produce for Princeton. They have three sophomores in double-digit scoring, so not only a big stage being undefeated, but here at Conseco, they may be a little nervous as they get started and they rebound. Rochester's not a big team. We'll see if Princeton can get the rebounding edge.
Both cities have brought good crowds to tonight's opening game. We'll have the opening tip-off for you in just a moment. After that, look at the St. Vincent Sports Performance. Keys to the game. Well, we're about set now for the opening tip-off. Rochester, 23-3, and the Princeton Tigers unbeaten in 28 games this year. Tremendous crowd. They've already opened up the upper decks here at Conseco for the crowd that's flowing over into those areas, and that's just terrific. Let's take a look at the starting lineup. First off, for the Princeton ball club, you take a look at, we talked about Trevor George. He averages 15-9. Jalen Packer in that starting lineup at guard at 14-3. The top scorer is actually Rontre Chavis at 16-7. So three of their starters averaging over double figures. Trevor George, by the way, 8.1 boards. Rondre at 6.1. And this Bison averages 59.5 points. The team averages 74.3, so they're going to have to get most of their scoring out of the starting lineup. Rochester head coach is Rob Malco in his seventh year. Rex Reinholdt, Sean Kelly, Dwayne Stiles, Mike Barnett, and I gave you the wrong head coach. Tom Weeks is the head coach. Bill Niederhaus and Brian Douglas, the assistant coaches for the Princeton Tigers. Now let's swing over to the Rochester side of things. And they have only one player starting at double digits. And that would be, as the guy that last talked about, Bruce Grimm, averaging 25 points a game and 4.9 rebounds. They do have a front line of Bowers, Lowe, and Grimm that average 3.9 Bowers, Lowe at 4.6, and Grimm at 4.9 rebounds. 54.3 points, 67.6 as a team. And here is Rob Malco, Rex Reinholdt, Sean Kelly, Dwayne Stiles, Mike Barnett, and his brother Mike Malco are the assistants for the Rochester Zebras at 23-3. Laz, if you take a look at those numbers, it looks like most of the scoring on both of these clubs will come out of the starting units.
That's true. In fact, Rochester's a little deceptive. They run a special offense we'll talk more about later, but it's not that these guys can't score in double figures. Oftentimes in a game they do, but there's no consistency when they do it.
What a shot, Laz! Right out of the box. Princeton getting a shot from Rondre Chavis when he literally was just trying to keep the ball alive.
6'4", he got right up by the rim and tipped that ball in.
So the Princeton ball club dressed in the white uniforms, and the turnover is forced. A good defense by Princeton. Take a look at this shot again, the first 2 points of the game.
A high lob pass, and look at almost, he gets undercut, Rondre does, and able to tip it in left-handed. A great way to start the game.
This is a little different than what you and Rob had earlier today when you went 4.5 minutes of that Class A game without any scoring.
We're going to get some scoring in this one.
7:19 to go, first quarter just getting underway. Princeton likes to score 74 points a game. Rochester 60, almost 68 first. So you would expect, Laz, a high-scoring game, right or wrong? Here's the long-range three. And right away, Evan Hall is in the scorebooks.
Expect a big-scoring game. That's right, Jerry. Both these teams like the offensive side, and they don't take long to put the ball up.
Rochester does allow only 46 points a game. Princeton only 54 points a game. So they can play defense, but literally both these clubs have outscored their opponents throughout the year. Block shot in the middle that time by Rondre Chavis, and the rebound comes off to Chavis. He'll get it back up court in a hurry. Packer in the corner, left-handed shot is short. The rebound thrown right inside on a beautiful pass, and the bucket by Brent George.
That's the other twin brother, just 4 points a game, but a senior, and he's in there to help wherever he can.
Well, the pace of the game pretty much lasts what you expected early on, a lot of activity. Straightaway look this time with no shot for Hoff. He has the only point so far for Rochester on the three-pointer. A minute 45 into the game. Baseline cut. Wide open left wing. 10-footer. Yep, back to home. Did Mark Bowers.
Nice shot there by Bowers. Just about 5 points a game. But 70% field goals Bowers makes. So he's taking those nice shots inside.
2 minutes into the game and already won three lead changes. So far, the big lead for Rochester is what they have right now with one. Ooh, what a hard hit on the floor, and a personal foul is going to be called. And the foul is going to be on Grimm. And last, he went down hard.
He did get bounced right back up. Good look at Trevor George there, 6'3" and a senior. And surprisingly, Jerry, this Princeton team undefeated with three sophomores in double-digit scoring. It's very rare to see that young a team go undefeated. A lot of these guys playing varsity ball for the first time, but they've had a wonderful season down there at Princeton. Several games winning by 3 points or less, but that being said, they never did lose a game.
Gold medals coming in for every free throw made today. Taco Bell is donating $10 up to $500 to the IHSA Centennial Scholarship Award. Here's the second free throw. It is good. Trevor George getting his first points of the evening. Trevor George, 15.9 per game, and another lead change at 4 lead changes already. 6-5 score with Princeton on top. Rochester in the dark uniforms almost tipped back up and almost tipped in by Trevor George on the defensive rebound. Well, this is an up-tempo game, and Rondre Chavis has his second bucket. Chavis averages 16-7. I mentioned that they have four players in double figures. They almost, Laz, have a six-man starting lineup because his brother, Dontre, averages 11.5 points per game himself off the bench.
Right, Dontre does not start. He gets a lot of playing time, though.
Long-range three, Bruce Grimm. Grimm down with 59 three-pointers on the year.
And he is a very good shooter. It's surprisingly not as many three pointers as you might think, but he likes to take the ball inside due to that the offense that the Rochester runs.
Yeah, this is the big lead of the game for Rochester at a couple of points. So the foul down in the corner down there.
Let's watch Princeton now. The high lob pass inside to Chavis, and he's able to finish it off with that left hand.
Number 30, Colt Meadows, his first.
The foul on Colt Meadows. That is number one on him. You saw the officials, Bob Anderson, Tracy Black, and Mike Stopers. Black and Stopers as the turnover is called against Princeton. Had a substitution coming back onto the court for Rochester, Austin Lowe. Black and Stopers working their first state finals. Bob Anderson is working his fourth state championship. Sean Lambert is the alternate, by the way. And we got a timeout. Here's a look at the Rochester Zebras, school of about 593. They're located about 90 miles north of Indianapolis. Members of the Three Rivers Conference. First championship game appearance, taking a championship in any sport. Now for the Princeton Tigers, they are about 150 miles to the southwest of Indy. Enrollment at 690, school colors red and white. Andy Elkins, the AD at Princeton. Mark Miller is the AD at Rochester. Interesting story on Mark Miller. He's the athletic director, Laz. He's also the football coach. He's been there since 1981 as the football coach. And they won the Class 2A state football title back in 87 with a 23-20 win over Ritter. That's their claim to fame up there.
Well, this offense that Rochester runs is from John Calipari, the Memphis offense. And you see the spread that they have. They don't have a big center, and they move the ball mostly on a drive, and then they dish it back out for an outside shot. There you see it didn't really need to drive that time, and that shot goes in by Shane.
That's the third. They have four field goals, three of which have been three-pointers. Baseline left side, good by Jordan Simmons.
But Princeton answers right back, a very good shooting team. So the reason they don't have another player in double figures is not because these kids can't score 15 or 20 a game. It's just it varies with this offense who's going to get the shot from game to game.
Oh, goodness, they are not bashful, that's for sure. Second three-pointer for Bruce Grimm. As a team, their percentage is not all that impressive from outside. Last, only 36%, but you wouldn't know it where they're shooting right now.
No, they're really hitting it well from the outside. No nerves here.
Will Grant George inside. Loose ball knocked away, out of bounds. It'll belong to Princeton.
And for those viewers, Jerry, who don't really have a team, you're from the Midwest, central part of Indiana. Old gold and black are Rochester's colors. Red and white are Princeton colors. Any colleges you know in Indiana about that?
That sounds like Purdue and your old alma mater, IU. Timeout on the floor. Less than four to go. 14-10 Rochester. 14-10 score. Rochester with its biggest lead of the game. Five lead changes already in this contest. Laz, a team comparison. One of the things that jumped out at me is free throws. You know, in the games you and I've done at the tournament, you know that could be a major factor toward the end of the contest.
Princeton just at 60%, but look at the scoring. A very high scoring game. Both teams shoot the ball very well, not necessarily from the three, but from that 2-point field goal range, and they don't allow many points on the defensive end, 46 and 53.
All right, halfway through period number one, Princeton in the white uniforms. As Laz pointed out, that black and gold of Rochester. Rochester on a break. Nice defensive strip that time by Trevor George.
See, Rochester will fast break when they can. And let's take a look. A nice lead pass out there. And Austin Lowe coming right at you. Not able to get that one on the rim, but Rochester retains possession.
Rochester having some difficulty just getting the ball inbounds. Finally do. Bounce inside. One of the few inside plays they've had. Right side, Austin Lowe. Lowe comes down hard, and he'll be called for the traveling violation. He hit the deck a ton. He's got some elbow guards on, and that may have saved him a problem. We'll take a look at it again.
Look at the good passing. Instead of taking a contested shot, Rochester has learned to pass the ball to the open guy. Ooh. And let him take a jumper. He did take a real spill on that elbow. Jumps right up, though.
Lowe with one of the top players on this ball club, a senior.
That was 22. Jordan Simmons, he gets the baseline jumper to go.
Second for him, Laz. And again, the pace just continues to be about as quick as it can be. For everything you guys did not see in the first two games today, we're seeing it's being made up for right now.
And slower paces in 1 and 2A. These teams both like to get it up and down. That's Tom Meeks. And there's Rob Macau, the Rochester coach. And they got to be pleased. There no nerve showing here. These kids are hot, ready to go.
Interesting to talk with Rob on Monday. We're excited about having his club here. Oh, baseline cut wide open, looking almost to travel, but nonetheless, Bowers got free for the bucket. They've spread the scoring out now. Four of the starters have scored. Only Austin Lowe not in the score column. Bowers now with four. Lead goes back to four. Little jump shot right inside the lane by Rondre Chavis. Chavis now for the half a dozen.
Rochester shooting 73% from the field, and Princeton 70%. These guys are both on fire.
Down to the corner, first to foul called against Princeton. That'll be the first foul against the ball club. And the foul is going to be on Dontre Chavis.
There's Tom Meeks, very interesting guy, Tom Weeks. He coached in Tennessee for 8 years at the high school level, and he's writing a book on the Civil War. How about that?
I read a little note on that. It's about the decisions made by the Civil War general. So that's pretty heavy stuff there, lad. You're writing one of those too, aren't you?
Not on that, but he is going to have a smart team out here, you can tell.
Inside, shot comes up short by Jordan Simmons. It'll be out of bounds and maintaining control of the Princeton Tigers.
Boy, Bruce Grimm was right there. Let's take a look at what happened here. Watch this good fast break. Four on one, four on two, and there's Grimm takes position. Looked like to me he got knocked down there.
Rondre Chavis in the lineup. Dontre, his brother, likewise was on the floor a moment or so ago. In fact, he's still out there right now, so the Chavis twins are on the court with 2:19 to play here in this opening period. Fast pace, you betcha, right from the get-go. Wide open look, right side. And the rebound taken off by Brody Shane. And they'll fire back up from outside, short off the rim by Bruce Grimm. Now the advantage again by Princeton on the driving layup. And a blocking foul will be tagged to Bruce Grimm. That'll be two on him, Laz, and they can't afford to get him in trouble.
Well, see, that's tough. When he takes that outside three-point shot, he's the only man back on D, and that's twice in a row now where he's trying to get back. The first time it looked like a charge that wasn't called, and now this time he does pick up his second foul.
Gold Meadows coming back onto the floor for Rochester. Brant George returns for Princeton. There's a look at the shooting early on in this game. 2 minute mark, opening quarter, Class 3A championship. Conseco Fieldhouse. As you look at it, it may not look full right now because the sections that are not full are going to be filled up by the 4A championship squads, but we've got a nice crowd on hand tonight.
Now by the fourth quarter, Jerry, all the stands will be full, and this will be the most fans these kids have played for in their life.
Yeah, I heard you commenting on that earlier today, Laz. That does have a little impact on it.
Yeah, and especially if one of the 4A teams starts cheering for one of the other 3A teams.
And a three-point field goal by Trevor Jones.
I'm telling you, the shooting in this game is unbelievable. Both teams back and forth, and it should be a one-point game just the way it is.
Another lead change. That's a half a dozen. Biggest lead so far for Princeton's been two. They're going to try to change it again, and they do with an outside shot by Colt Meadows, who just came off the bench. That is the fifth three-pointer in the quarter for Rochester. Seven lead changes already, John.
Rochester's taking wide open shots, and that's part of this offense. Let's take a look. They'll dribble in, they'll draw the defense, and then they look for the open man. They don't look to shoot right away when they get the ball. They look to pass to see who's more open than I am. It's a very unselfish offense. The coaches told me it took until December for the kids to figure this out, that this is not a usual thing for them to do, but it gets them open shots time and time again.
There it's off. That's his second three. Of the eight field goals they have, six of them have been three-pointers, and a 30-second timeout is going to be taken by Princeton. Their ball club is now down by five, the biggest lead of the game for Rochester. And they have come out storming. They have hit Princeton is at 7 of 11. Rochester is at 8 out of 13 so far.
All right, watch the unselfishness now. Grimm gets the ball. Wide open in the corner is Bowers. And I'm sorry, that's 23, Evan Hoff. He's able to make that one. There's another look at it. He gets it wide open in the corner and lets it go. There's a little advantage that Rochester had. One of their assistant coaches is Mike Barnett. By the way, his son Corey plays at IU as a walk-on. But Mike Barnett is a friend of John Calipari's. He went down to Memphis last summer and got some information about this Memphis offense. Calipari sent them some tapes, and in the fall, the coach studied. I asked Rob Malkow, it's hard for a coach to change his offense. He said, you know, our players just fit that offense. I thought I'd give it a try. It's got him a state championship game.
Super. Here's the field goal numbers right here. Nice of Calipari, by the way, to be that cooperative.
Coaches are always helpful. Now, zone defense by Rochester. Maybe to help Bruce Grimm stay in the ball game without picking up another foul.
Princeton in the white uniforms again, in the old gold uniforms. Rochester brought four under the hoop and finally going to be out of bounds. And last touch by one of the Rochester players. Substitution now for Rochester. Austin Lowe coming back onto the court. So far, starting was not scoring.
All right, good outside shot. And this is the height advantage that Princeton has really at all the positions. And they battle for that ball. Rontre Chavis finally comes up with it. Bruce Grimm does come out of the ball game for a short time as he substituted for just now at that timeout.
Good block out, rebound by Bowers. He averages four rebounds a game. 30 seconds to go now here in the first quarter in a high scoring affair. 22-17 in favor of Rochester, trying to add three more, and they do. Evan Hoff with his third triple of the first quarter and the seventh for the ball club.
He averages just about 5 points a game.
8-point lead, big margin, long range three, good at the other end. Ron Craig Chavis, whatever you can do, I can do better. That's 9 points for Chavis in the opening period with 2 seconds. 1 second, here's a three at the buzzer. Off the mark, no good, and a wild and woolly 3A first quarter is in the books. After one at Conseco Fieldhouse, Rochester 25, Princeton 20 for the 3A championship. It's the first quarter numbers, lads, and they're off the charts.
Yeah, 60% shooting Rochester, 53 Princeton, 7 of 10. Rochester really nailing that three-point shot and not many points in the paint.
Evan Hoff with 9 points led Rochester. 9 points likewise for Rontre Chavis. And the second quarter getting underway. 7 lead changes. Here's the shot from the quarter court right side. Bruce Grimm. So that we talked about early on, Laz. He averages 25-2 a game. That's his 8 point of the night.
He doesn't take bad shots. He got his feet set. He slipped there a little bit, but waited till he recovered and then took that shot.
On the corner, off the mark, batted free inside that top. Trevor George kept it alive, but Rochester comes out of there with it. They will run the break in a hurry. Bruce Grimm not afraid to let it fly on the corner. You pointed out, Laz, nothing coming from underneath. As the height advantage of Princeton's keeping him out of the middle. Here's a held ball. Possession error will get the ball back to Princeton.
Now I think Rochester's figured that out. You know, it's played just like that. As Bowers tries to take it inside, gets a block. Why not make that pass to an open player and let him take a shot? Good backdoor play and smart play by Grimm to stop instead of taking all the way in. And he hits a nice 10-footer.
Princeton unranked in the season rankings both the Associated Press and the basketball coaches. In the final poll, AP had them number one. Basketball coaches had them number eight. Of course, the basketball coaches rank them without classification. So number eight in the state overall. Battle inside. You can hear the running and the grunting. Knocked away to belong to Princeton. Against Greensburg in the semi-state, Laz, I guess we shouldn't be surprised at the shooting because against Greensburg, Princeton hit 14 of their last 18 field goal attempts.
Now, when the season started, you got three sophomores going to have big-time play. No one knew who this team was, but as the season rolled on and these kids started to adjust, three of them in double-figure scoring, they rose right to the top, an undefeated season so far.
Rochester lost its fourth game of the year at Warsaw by 12. They lost a little later on to Witco by 3. Then they lost to Peru 3 from the last of the regular season by 7. So their average loss margin 7.3. Driving to the hoop, goes off the rim. Grimm with a good job getting inside that time. In the middle, trying to bounce the ball inside low to Dontre Chavis. And a foul.
All right, watch the read from behind the back. See the left hand on the lower back. Jason Smith picks up that foul, 6'4 senior. He's in there to rebound and play some defense. Not much of a score, but Rochester has plenty of kids that can score those points.
14 foul now against Rochester. Second quarter, a minute and a half old.
And one of these things, Jerry, these kids aren't used to. Rochester's average winning margin, 21 points a game. Princeton, 20. So they've really been in situations where they've won by big margins. As you mentioned, they've never played a top 10 team in the state and on their road to the final game. So the competition is really good, and they're not used to playing in close games a lot.
Sixth turnover of the game now for Princeton in this early going second quarter. Here's another turnover this time against Rochester. Last year, and I also chatted about the fact in the semi-state that you really don't know. Rochester doesn't play anybody that Princeton plays and vice versa, so there's no real measuring stick here.
No, and that's what's neat about this kind of game. The North and the South matchup, the black and gold, the red and the white, and just kids having fun firing that ball up. It has been a great game to watch so far.
Princeton now in the white uniforms at the basketball. Trevor George has over 1,200 career points. Left side baseline, Jordan Simmons. Simmons now with a half a dozen. His average is just under 9 per game, so they're spreading their wealth around likewise. The only starter that did not score for Princeton was Jalen Packer. Austin Lowe, the only starter that did not score for Rochester. Long rebound, chased down to the corner, Austin Lowe. And we've got a hurt player, Princeton. That is Trevor George. And boy, they cannot afford to have him go down.
That ball was flying around and players were going after it. Didn't see what caused Trevor George to slip.
And for a moment, Laz, I thought it was a shoulder, but he's kind of favoring the left knee. Let's take one more look at it here.
Let's watch for 20. There he is in the middle of the screen there. Oh, he stepped on the ankle of Austin Lowe, and it caused him to miss a step, and his knee came down funny, that left knee. Let's see if he can get back in this game.
Well, Tom Weeks has taken him out of the lineup right now. They've got him on the sideline, and the trainer's got to look at him very, very carefully. They can't afford to lose him. Here's a kickball. 5:32 to go now here in the first half. Trevor George, number 9 scorer in Gibson County history, the only Princeton player with more is Justin Lynch, who finished his career with 1381. Out of bounds, it'll stay in the possession of Rochester. First 21 season since 1974 for Princeton, overall school record for victories as they come in here with a 23-3 mark. Wide open look, Grimm. All of a sudden, those threes that were falling in the first quarter are not here in this quarter. Grant George maybe last turned out a pretty good shot that time. Try to make one extra pass to no avail. Pull up out front, Grimm again. Rebound taken off by Lowe. Back out to the point, Grimm comes over on the near side, and a tripping foul will be tagged on Dontre Chavis, his first.
Great job of passing the ball around by Rochester and then making sure they take the good open shot. And good news, Trevor George will be checking back into the lineup. There he is. So that knee, not a serious injury.
Check it. That's the second personal foul on Dontre. In fact, the only two fouls against Princeton belong to Dontre Chavis. Good up close look at Trevor George. Dontre going out of the lineup now with 3 minutes gone here in the second quarter. Rebound taken out by Princeton. All the way to the hoop. Nice bounce pass over on the right wing to Brant George. Nothing available. They bring it out. Come right back inside again. Good offensive rebound. The putback is good by Rontre. 11 points now. He's the top scorer for Princeton.
He was surrounded by Rochester players and did not let that bother and went up strong at 6'4". Got that rebound basket.
27-24. The lead was at one time 8 points for Rochester. They'll try to get Yedden back, and they will. Second field goal for Brody Shane. They have both got to the 3-point zone. Half a dozen for Brody. His average is 9.7. Heading toward the halfway mark of the second quarter, and the pace is slow just a tad. First quarter 25-20 in favor of Rochester. Now it is a 30-24 ball game. Rochester still on top. Pull up right side, Simmons. Off the mark badly. Rebound comes up into the hands of Austin Lowe.
Neither team takes it inside a lot, Jerry, and that allows for the clock to keep running. Wow, what a shot there.
There's Lowe. I just mentioned last, he had not scored.
Austin Lowe, he finally gets his first hoop, the 6'1 senior. But because, hey, let's take a look at it. There's not a lot of inside play. You don't have many fouls. Here's one of the few inside plays we've had. Points in the paint, a good leg pass on that fast break. So both teams taking the jump shots from the outside. Not a lot of whistles, a lot of action up and down the floor. Very quick game.
Fouls on Brad George, number 1 on the 6'2 senior. And at the line now for Rochester, number 24, Austin Lowe. Lowe, not a particularly good free throw shooter, only 59% of the year. Made that one look easy for his first points of the game, the old-fashioned three-point play. With 3:53 to go in the opening half, Eric Canseco, the 3A title is on the line. And right now, Rochester has the biggest lead of the game by either club. They're up by 9, 33-24. Rochester has outscored Princeton 8-4 last here in the second quarter. Shooting has cooled down just a bit. Rochester now shooting 48% on 12 out of 25. but nonetheless they've been able to expand that lead to 9.
Yeah, Princeton is cooling off 3 of 10. There you see that Tom Weeks trying to figure out how to get that offense going again. He's down 9 points right now. Wants to cut that lead here with the last 4 minutes before the half.
Here comes now Tom Weeks in his 4th year as the head coach of the school, a winning percentage of 63%, 62-37. Also coached down in Tennessee at Westview Martin and Henry County. Spent 7 years there, as a matter of fact. Nice defensive rebound turned in by Rochester. In a hurry comes Bruce Grimm.
Well, Rochester's really got a block out. They've done a nice job there. And now you see Grimm slowing it down a little bit.
You can see Tom Weeks on the sideline trying to get the defensive player right up on top of Bruce Grimm, because Grimm has a trigger finger. He's not afraid to let it go. Now a number break on the other end. 3-on-2 all the way in for the layup. Rebound taken down, put right back up. This time it's good by Trevor George. He's now with 7 points.
Yeah, great reaction to that rebound. Trevor George goes after it and then goes up right with it strong.
Shot is blocked. Grimm shot blocked. Apparently some body contact. Bob Anderson making the call. It looks to be on Ron Chavis. Here's the activity at the other end.
All right, watch Princeton. They're coming right at you. Wild shot there. Doesn't quite go, but Dontre is right there. I'm sorry, Trevor George right there for the rebound, the putback.
Second foul on George. Going to the line now is Grimm. First trip to the line. 77% free throw shooter on the season. 8 points so far in the game. An average of 25-2. He'll get a couple.
Rochester 8 of 14 from the 3-point line. That's excellent shooting, and that's enabling them to get this lead.
Grimm knocks them both down. He's with 10. Grimm 6th in the state in scoring this year. He averaged in the tournament last almost 27 points a game. And they're going to need his scoring tonight. Here's a battle inside. The putback off the mark. The rebound taken off by one of the shortest guys out there. Number 12, Brody Shane. Here's the basket. On the defensive steal, and the basket is good, and the foul is called. The foul is going to be tagged on Brody Shane, and that'll be one on him.
Well, watch Princeton. They missed the shot, but they start to pick up right away. They don't fall back. Two defenders right there. A nice steal by Chavis. Ends up in a basket, chance for 3 points. Rochester needs to look down the floor if Princeton's going to guard him right there when they get the rebound.
3-point play is good. Trevor George with 5 points in the first quarter. He scored 5 here in the second. Now with a total of 10, his average is 16 per. And all of a sudden, he's back to a 6-point ball game. 9-point lead at one time by the team with the basketball, Rochester. Oh, what a shot by Grimm.
He was off balance and able to still get that shot.
He goes back to 8 last night. Totally off balance and still managed to have a good looking shot.
That's a shooter's touch right there. It's only a 10-foot shot, but still difficult.
Here's Brad George going in front of the lane. Nothing good. Rebound snared by Austin Lowe, who averages just a touch under 5 rebounds a game. Less than 2 to go now here in the first half.
All right, now watch this offense. Spread it out. Nobody's down on the block. Only a man at the free throw line. That allows for back cuts. Let's see how long Rochester wants to hold this ball.
Knocked away. Good defense employed inside by Trevor George.
So when you spread the offense like that, Jerry, it allows for that drive to the basket. If the defense, if you get around your man, there's nobody to help and you get that quick shot.
Rondre Chavis will go out of the lineup. Keenan Johnson with his first appearance now for Princeton. Johnson, the 6'1 junior, has played in 23 of the 28 games this year. Here's Grimm. Switching man to man now as they go back out almost to the point of Brody Shane.
So the release spot is at the free throw line there. And then if you get in trouble and need to pick up a dribble, go to the free throw line, then you can bring it right back out.
Well, as they're giving every indication of playing for the final shot.
Might be, unless they can get a drive to the basket and a nice jump shot. They've got the lead. They're up 8 points. Love to take an 8 or 10 point lead into the locker room.
Well, they're pretty much on target. They average 68 points a game, and they're at 37 right now as we head to halftime with exactly 1 minute to go. Grimm starts to make the cut. Basket would not have counted had it gone. A foul prior to the attempted shot. It was clearly a hit. Keenan Johnson. And on Keenan, that'll be personal foul number one. Johnson will go out. They'll return Ronfre Chavis to the lineup. That's the 15 foul against Princeton. Now we're inside a minute. John, it's a pretty simple looking offense, but obviously more complicated than it appears.
And it takes a while to get the hang of it, but you can tell that they really have become effective with it. You got to get Watts getting trapped in the corner like that. Good defense. Princeton really puts a good pressure on this offense right now, though.
Wide open, right side baseline. Mark Bowers did not take the shot. 30 seconds to go now in the opening half. Very content, Austin Lowe. Now they'll bring it back out at the point again with Brody Shane. Shane almost got in trouble. Now here's the foul from behind on Ronfre Chavis. And that'll be the first against him and the sixth against the ball club. So still no shots involved. Rochester ranked number 23 in the state in offense this season. They were tied for 31st in the state in defense, and their average win margin was number 3 in the state. That's during the regular season. During the regular season, Glass is pointing out the win margin. They won games by almost 29 per. Now the turnover with 16-7 will give the ball back to Princeton. So they spent about a minute and a half or more and didn't get anything out of it as Colt Meadows comes back onto the floor for the Zebras. And Bruce Grimm will head to the sideline. Grimm getting out of there with two personal fouls. 16-7 to go here in the opening half. See what Princeton wants to do. Well, the second quarter slowed down considerably after a 25-20 first quarter. 10 seconds to play, double team and stolen away. Ronfre Chavis tried to make something happen that just wasn't there. Here's the pull up shot by Shane off the mark, and that's going to take care of the first half. And what a first half it was. Rochester outscoring Princeton 12-9 in that second quarter. And let's go to John Laskowski. Las.
All right. Thanks, Jerry. Coach, great job in this first half. Your offense took an 8 3-point shots you made in that first half.
Well, we don't want to live and die by the three, but we have moments when we can knock them down, and the guys are comfortable with it right now. So as long as we're knocking down shots, we'll take them.
I like that offense, drive and kick. The kids are hitting the open shots.
Well, they are. And as long as we're open, now we just got to be a little more patient at times and not take such quick shots.
All right. Good luck in the second half, Coach.
Thank you.
Jerry, back to you.
All right. Halftime scores, Rochester 37, Princeton 29. 12 points for Bruce Grimm, 10 for Trevor George, 11 for Ronfre Chavis for Princeton. Halftime activities coming up next.
Austin Lowe, 3 points.
With Phil Gardner now, the assistant commissioner for the IHSAA. And Phil, I'll tell you, what a great first half. Teams up and down the floor. Your thoughts on that first half?
Great first half, exactly, John. Princeton with the athleticism that's really well coached, and then you've got Rochester just shooting the threes and a very disciplined team, and it's made for a great half. Very, very competitive and just fun to watch.
You've had a long career in administration at the high schools in Indiana. Now your first year on the job as assistant commissioner at the IHSA. How's that gone so far?
It's gone well, and this is kind of the utopia of it. The tournament all comes together, and what you find is there's a lot of dedicated people doing a lot of good things that care about what they're doing that make this such a great event. And I'm just a small part of that, kind of pulling it together, but the history's way on my side, and it's showing up tonight.
Well, we appreciate the work you do so much. Thanks, Phil.
Thank you, John.
All right, Jerry, back to you.
All right, Phil Gardner getting his first taste of what it's like to sit behind the big Oval Office up on North Meridian Street. Halftime, 37-29, Rochester in the 3A championship.
Here's some highlights from that first half. Good pass inside. That's Jordan Simmons getting the basket there. Nice outside shot this time by Ronfre Chavis. He's able to knock that down. Bruce Grimm there on the lead. He dishes off to Evan Hall for one of the 8 3-point shots that Rochester made. And now a fast break. But again, always looking for the open man. Austin Lowe gets a 3-point play with a tough layup right there.
And there's the free throw, our field goal shooting. Just both teams just under 50%. But look at the big difference. 8-2 in three-point shots made. The rebounding battle is even. Turnovers about equal as well. But a few more points in the paint for Princeton. We'll see if Rochester can keep shooting from the outside as well as they did in the first half.
And that is our halftime report tonight, sponsored by St. Vincent's Sports Performance. Back with more in just a moment. 37-29, Rochester. We're about set to begin the second half. Laz, one of the points that we made, Rochester's score, Bruce Grimm, he's the only guy in double figures at 25.2. Grimm had the only double figure scoring at 12 in the first half, but they've really spread it out well with the rest of the guys.
That's the nature of that offense, as we talked about. Grimm's got to watch it, though. He's got two fouls for Princeton. George Brandt and Dontre Chavis both have two. If either of those three players pick up their third foul here quickly, it could impact this game.
All right, so we'll switch ends, and the Princeton Tigers will be on defense now as Rochester works to the left of our television cameras. Ball thrown away. Last touch, they say, by Princeton. The time of the penetration by Evan Hoff.
It's tough for Rochester to drive all the way to the basket with the size advantage that Princeton has. So see if they settle for that jump shot. Drive in until you get covered, and then try to hit your teammate for an open shot.
Ball away, five-footer out front. Nothing doing. Knocked away again, out of bounds. And it'll belong to Princeton. If you join us late in that first quarter, it was up just a track meet out there. Rochester had 7 of their 9 field goals from the three-point range and led 25-20. At halftime, they're 37-29. They've led by as many as 9. We've had 7 lead changes and 1 tie, and the tie was back at 8. Three-point field goal. Jalen Packer, he's the only starter that had not scored in the first half. Packer averaging 14-3. They're going to need something out of him. 1 minute into this third quarter. Nice defensive stop by Trevor George. And thrown away, but will stay in the hands of Rochester. Rochester shared the conference title with North Miami and Whitco with records of 6-1 this year. In the sectional, their first postseason win over Plymouth since 1971. They went on an 18-0 run in the third quarter of that game in the sectional to pull away with that victory, 57-38. Princeton comes off of the defensive board.
Good give and go there. Just couldn't get that layup. Rochester still cold here at the start of this third quarter.
Just going to say, Laz, I've been watching Mark Bowers. He is all over Juantre Chavis in the middle of that time, and that time he kind of disconcerted him to the point that Chavis was going one way and the pass went right by him.
Yeah, probably everybody on his team thought he was taking that shot, turned their backs, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Out of a 5-point ball game now with Rochester with the basketball and the lead. I don't see that same offense out there right now. Has it changed?
Well, it looks like Princeton stepped up and not let him drive the lane as much, although Grimm got through that time. But yeah, a little more intensity now by Princeton on the defensive end.
14 points now for Grimm. 5:55 to go. Follow a shot short. Knocked out of bounds. It'll go over to Rochester. Couple of subs now for Princeton. Number 42, Dontre Chavis coming back onto the floor. And for the Rochester Zebras, and they've pulled Meadows into the lineup. Meadows, a 5'10 junior. Dontre Chavis, a 5'7 sophomore. It was his brother at 6'4. Apparently, they didn't get to the table at the same time, John.
Well, they one substitute for the next right there at that time, at that exchange.
Rebound Princeton.
And Rochester starting a little cold from the field here in this third quarter.
Oh, what a beautiful rebound by Jordan Simmons. And undercut and the foul against Rochester.
Rochester held its own that first half, 14-15 on the boards. But you can see the height advantage. Nice rebound that time by Jordan Simmons. And a foul out of bounds to Princeton.
Colt Meadows picking up his second personal. Here's the inbounds pass. The shot is good. The basket will count. Andre now with 13 points. He'll go to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Bodies on Mark Bowers.
Coach Tom Weeks really did a nice job with the heavy. Got his players to work more on the inside. Here's a special inbounds pass. The high lob. And the basket by Rontre Chavis. Just came in the game and right there ready to rock and roll as soon as that pass comes up.
Rebound. Rontre. Foul of the ensuing shot called against Rochester. And going to the line now for Princeton, Rontre Chavis, and for every free throw made tonight, Taco Bell is donating $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award. A foul on Evan Hawk, by the way. That's the first of the game against Evan.
This is where Princeton is weak. 54% for Rontre, 65 for Rontre. So free throws could come to cost him if this game comes right down to the end.
Rontre getting his first points of the line, Laz, and now they get that full court pressure tossed in there by Princeton. Well, they are all over Evan Hawk on the far sideline. They break it, get the shot away, tip to the air, and the rebound danced around with Rontre Chavis coming out with it. Near side, Jalen Packer. Packer slips and falls. They get called for the turnover. That's 10 turnovers now on Princeton so far this game.
Just a little too quick coming down the floor. Not quite sure what he wanted to do. Ends up in a turnover, but this pressing defense has also impacted Rochester. Boy, lucky there not to lose it on that play.
Well, those threes were falling like leaves off the trees early on in this contest, but not so much right now.
And that's why Coach Rob Malco cautioned us at halftime, you know, eight's a lot of threes, but we don't live and die by the three. Let's try to get some twos.
Well, Rochester's defense lines is just smothering Princeton inside.
I want to force them to take that outside shot. They don't want the ball. Those shots coming from in the lane.
3-point field goal attempt is off the mark. Batted free, saved, and going hard into the stands is Austin Lowe. Apparently he stepped on the baseline, so the ball will go back over to Princeton. Princeton uses a lot of pressure. Have used a lot of pressure when this happened. That's turned this game around.
It has. They're right back in it now with this 2 points by Rochester here in the first 3.5 minutes of this half. They're not getting the good shots they got in the first half, but credit the Princeton defense. Now they're on a 3-quarter court trap.
Princeton comes off of the rebound. They'll bring it back up, and Rochester in a hurry to get back defensively. Inside, the shot off the mark by Trevor George. Rebound, put up, good, score, foul call. Mark Bowers will get hit with a foul. That's just pure power that time by Rontre Chavis.
Now, big strong move right here. Good defense by Rochester, not the foul, but look at the leap that time by Rontre, and somehow gets that shot to go with the right hand. Excellent work here. Surrounded by two Rochester players and gets it to go.
Completes the play. He has 5 of the 9 points in the third quarter put up by the Princeton Tigers.
And we have us a ball game right now, Jerry. One-point game. Rochester still in the lead.
Rochester had a 9-point lead at 1 point. They were up by 8 at halftime. Ball knocked away. Lead pass up court. Here comes Rontre. Missed the dunk. Rebound taken out of there by Bruce Grimm, who averages 5 per game. They'll go the other way. Grimm feeds off into the corner. Laz, are not, well, I'm just going to say they're not taking the shots with reckless abandon like they were. And just as I say that, Grimm gets one fly from outside. The inside, they go to Austin Lowe. Lowe has it taken away that time by Trevor George. Now we'll go the other way. No advantage on the numbers, but they'll pull up from right out front. Missed the shot. Rebound taken away. And knocked away from Rontre Chavis, and the foul is called.
Well, if you like up and down action, this is the game to watch right here. Both teams playing hard. Shooting percentage is way down from that first half, but the action is really intense out there, both ends of the floor.
Bowers picking up his 3rd foul. And we'll have 3:25 to go now here in the third quarter. And it's a good look at Rochester head coach Rob Malco, a graduate of Winnemac High School and St. Xavier College. Spent 8 years as the head coach of the girls team at Rochester High. Timeout, 1-point ball game. Princeton has outscored Rochester 9-2 in this third quarter. Lazo looked over here to Terry Moore, who's doing our stats for us. All I could see was a blur.
Yeah, his hand's getting tired, isn't it?
I'm telling you what, it is up and down basketball, but things have really settled down. A terrific first quarter if you like fast-paced basketball. The pace is still quick, but the shooting has gone, as John pointed out, downhill considerably.
And Rochester's can't get any buckets, just 2 points here in this third quarter.
Wide open look by Trevor George, way short. Here's the putback, gets off the mark. Second try is finally good. Ron Craig Chambers is a man among men out there right now, lads. He has 7 points in this period.
Well, and that has been the difference, the rebounding edge and follow-up shots by Princeton. They've now got the lead.
That's the 8th lead change and the first time that Princeton's led since it was 17-16.
What a great start to this third quarter.
2 minutes, 50 seconds remain here in quarter number three, and the pressure that Princeton's come up with has really changed this basketball game.
A different defense now. They use a half-court trap, and Rochester can't run the same offense.
Bowers getting inside, misses to Gimme, puts it back up and scores, and they'll go to the line for the foul on Dontre Chavis.
Finally a bucket for Rochester. It's after Bowers missed an easy shot. Let's watch this. He's got a layup. Doesn't get it to go, but stays after it. In fact, fights a teammate for the ball. Gets that layup and the foul. Tried to put a little too much spin on that first shot that went right around the rim.
They opted to put the foul on 22 instead of 42. 22 is Jordan Simmons, and that'll be the first foul of the game against him. Free throw is good. Mark Bowers now with 3 points in the quarter, 7 on the night. He had 4 points in the opening quarter, got shut out in period number two. Bob Malko looking off to the sideline. Inside shot against all kinds of pressure and a good looking effort by Jordan Simmons. He's now totally 8 points.
He had two players on him and still made that shot. And now here's that three quarter court trap.
Open look, left wing good. Now that's the way that Grant was shooting at the outset of the contest. That's his third three of the game. He had two in the first quarter.
Well, Bowers made the play there. He drew the defense to him and then right back out to Grimm, who was wide open, makes a much easier shot.
Less than two to go in a fast-paced ball game. Third quarter of play, 3A title on the line here at Conseco. Princeton in the white uniforms, Rochester in the old gold and black. As Laz pointed out, it's almost like an IU-Purdue matchup. Inside, shot short, tipped away off in the corner in front of the Princeton bench, and saved down there by Rochester. And again, the pressure, and it'll be out of bounds to Princeton. Apparently, the Rochester player in this case, Hope Meadows, stepped on the baseline.
All right, let's watch the last basket. Good pass out to Grimm, wide open, and the jump shot is good. Good pressure. Princeton trapped right on the baseline there, and Rochester couldn't get out of the trap.
Princeton has only 8 points in the paint in this game, and I think last maybe all of those maybe have come in this quarter the way things have gone. And here's an offensive foul. It'll be against Trevor George. First of the game on Trevor.
Let's watch it right there. Contact made. Grimm was in good position, and the foul goes against Princeton.
Well, here's that full court pressure now by Princeton. Interesting to note, the superintendent, Dale McQuiston, said this is our economic development package, stimulus package. They had almost 3,000 in their gym for their tournaments. And, of course, we forget sometimes that you've got to pay expenses at the high school level, so it's nice to see that. Of course, they hosted the sectional beating Gibson Southern Boonville at Evansville Memorial. In that Boonville game, by the way, Packer had 26 points. And Trevor George at 23.
Good block inside again by Princeton using that height.
Out to a minute to play now in the third period. Open look right side. Dontre. Rebound taken off by Rochester. Holt Meadows, who averages just over 2 per game, comes off of the big move. Now they're inside a minute. Almost a steal and a foul. Foul will be against Jalen Packer. That'll be the first of the game against him.
Really have to be careful with these passes because Princeton jumps to the ball so quickly. The near steal that time. Grimm did a nice job of moving to the ball, and that caused the contact and the foul. Third team foul now on Princeton. Rochester has 5 here in the quarter.
Rochester now in no particular hurry. They're going to slow things down. Coach Rob Malko out talking to his players on the far sideline, right at the top of your screen. ...30 seconds to go here in the third. 45-42 Rochester. They lost the lead. Now they've got it back up to three again. They've led by nine. They have trailed by three. And we've had a couple of ties in this game. Now we're down to 11 seconds to go. Quickly pressure tossed at him by Grant George. Here's the pull-up shot. Nothing doing. Rebound taken down by Brody Shane. Off the mark. 2 seconds. 1 second. Stolen. It's good. If it goes, it's off the mark. We've gone through three. Through three for the 3A championship. That man's ball club, Rob Malco, right now with a lead at 45-42 as we head toward the final 8 minutes at Conseco. Well, as the key player for Princeton in that third quarter was Ronpre Chavis. He had 7 points and a half a dozen rebounds. There is the father of Bruce Grimm. And his son has 17 points right now, an average of 25-2. They rely on him for their scoring.
Yep, and his dad was quite a scorer, too. Left-handed, as I remember. Had 2 great years at Rochester. Finished his senior year at Plymouth High School up in just north of Rochester.
Led them to the sectional and the regional titles back in 1973. Fourth quarter just getting underway. Rebound taken by Rochester. We'll bring it back. Well, this Princeton pressure, John, really turned things around. Now it goes off the foot of Bruce Grimm out of bounds, belongs to Princeton.
Yeah, hard to dribble against this type of pressure. You need to pass that ball. And Rochester turnovers really piling up now.
It's 11. Grimm and Lowe were named first team all three Rivers Conference. Grimm earned the honor for the third straight year. Lowe for the first time. And Lowe was also a first team all three Rivers Conference wide receiver in football this fall. 30 seconds into the fourth quarter. Nice offensive rebound by Grant George. Wide open look from outside. Rebound taken down by Trevor George. And all of a sudden, Temple's getting a little bit tested. It'll be a foul called against Rochester.
Let's watch it. Wide open shot, but the long rebound on the three-point shot. Trevor George able to get that rebound. See, one official called jump ball, but the official closer called the foul.
Foul was on Nate Basham, a 5'11 sophomore, his first personal foul. Oh, beautiful steal inside that time by Colt Meadows. It looked for all the world as so Princeton was going to get an offensive rebound. Now here's a foul. I'm telling you, things are getting physical out here. Grant George with his third.
Well, Princeton's really changed this game with their full court pressure, and they're taking the ball inside almost every possession. They missed the shot. Now watch this. Grimm comes up, and boom, there's the foul. But Rochester's got to know there's going to be pressure everywhere. Good adjustment by Tom Weeks here at halftime for this Princeton team.
Talking about football, Jason Smith, also a member of the football team, as they got a couple of points at the other end by Grimm.
See, that time he didn't try to take it up to the rim, had a little fall away shot, able to hit it.
Princeton back on the offensive side of the ball. They're down by five again, 47-42. Long range shot, nobody inside the block out. Colt Meadows comes off with the rebound. In a hurry, up court, wide open look by Hawk. Rebound sneered out of there by Ronpre Chavis, averaging just over 6 rebounds per game. Ronpre, as we pointed out, had a 6 point, seven, a 6 rebound, 7 point third quarter.
All right, let's watch the Princeton offense now. They'll move the ball and try to get it inside and try to use some height and then go for that offensive board. It's been their best weapon, really, to get the ball close, that offensive rebound.
That Zebra defense is really tucked in tight.
Well, they want to they want Princeton to take the outside shot.
Reach in foul, Austin Lowe. That'll be the first of the game against the 6'1 senior. Rochester has won 4 football championships in the history of the school. They won the football championship in 87, boys golf in 80, boys track in 1918, and girls basketball in 2004. Coming up later on tonight on the Indiana Cable Network at the 4A championship game for you. Fort Wayne Stoddard, Bloomington South. Princeton looking to become the 11th team to go undefeated and win a state championship. Trevor George's first points in the second half, 11 so far in the game.
Very calm. There's the Bloomington South team. They are underneath the basket. We'll be going in shortly to get dressed and chance to be another undefeated state champion team.
12-point job for Trevor George. 47-44 in favor of Rochester. The guys in the north have come down and played a terrific game. They've led at every quarter stop, 25-20, 37-29, and 45-42.
Better job that time. Rochester passed the ball all the way down the floor and not as much risk for a steal.
There's the turnover into the hands of Packer. Here's the layup at the other end by Rontre Chavis. 20 points down for Rontre. His average is 16-7. Also third on the club and assist at 3.5 per.
Princeton's keeping the pressure up even at the half court when Rochester comes down to score.
Ball out of bounds, belongs to Princeton. John, I'm still curious. Your point was so well made in the first half, the way they were setting the guy right at the free throw line and working off of him, and I'm not seeing that in the second half.
And they're taking four shots. Grimm was not in a good position that time, took that shot. In the first half, they would have passed out to an open man for an open shot.
Just under 3 minutes gone here in this fourth quarter. 1-point ball game with Rochester on top, 47-46. Princeton with the basketball. Once again, they're just giving Trevor George nowhere to play inside. Looks like almost a five-man zone inside right now.
Right in the lane. You're right, Jerry.
Nice offensive board, and the putback is good by Trevor.
He is so good rebounding that he's really made his offense just going after the ball.
Trevor George now with 14, and they turn the ball over again. Well, that's a critical part of the game right now. That lead change, by the way, was the third of the second half and the 10th in the game. 4:10 to play now. The second 4:20 to play here in the fourth and final period. They used the pick and roll, but Trevor George hangs on to the basketball. Here's Packer, only a sophomore. And Chavis, likewise a sophomore. Right out front, follow-away shot is not a good one, out of bounds off the hands of Jalen Packer. Rochester over the last 5 years, a record of 76-39. They've not had a losing season since 03-04. That was their fourth consecutive losing season. So enter Rob Malco, and in 7 years at the school, 66% winning percentage, 107 victories, 56 defeats. Halfway through the fourth quarter, John.
A great job he's done with this program since coming on. And let's see if Rochester can't get settled down here a little bit to get back to their game of good shots, move the ball around. And it's a great job of contrasting styles. Princeton wants to pound that ball inside and hit the offensive boards. And Rochester wants to get good open shots from any player they can.
Andre Chavis with his second personal foul. We've got a timeout. 3:53 to go, fourth quarter. Princeton 48, Rochester 47. Well, Dante and Rondre Chavis, both 6'4 sophomores. We expected, we talked a lot about Dante coming off the bench. Here's the 3-point field goal percentages by half. Rondre having a terrific second half. Lazzy has 20 points, 9 of those in the second half. And Dante, who averages 11.5, with only 1 point on a free throw in that third quarter. So the two youngsters, the 6'4 sophomores, one is doing what we expected. Dante so far not getting on track in this ball game.
Now both teams 1 of 8 from behind the arc, so that's not where you're going to win this game. Got to get good open shots. Look at two players now on Grimm. See if he can find the open man.
3.5 to go now here in the fourth quarter. Princeton on top by a single, 48-47. Rochester a little more deliberate with the basketball than we saw him early on. Here's Grimm off balance. Might have been deflected. And into the hands of Princeton. Here come the Tigers.
Now it's tied, it's turned. A 1-point lead and the ball. 3 minutes to go. Let's see if Princeton can get the good shot.
Princeton's biggest lead of the game was 3, and that was clear back in the first half of this game. Now let's see if Princeton wants to slow things down. They don't appear to be in any particular hurry. Both ball clubs well below their scoring norm. Rochester averaging 68 points a game, Princeton averaging 74 per. And the way the game started, 25-20 after the first quarter, they were right on target. A lot of scoring, but things have changed dramatically since then.
Spin that ball to get it to go. Let's watch this now. He gets to the right and avoids the charge and spins it. You see that English he had on and got it to go in. That is a really tough play.
Well, they have called a foul on Trevor George of Princeton as the ball was coming up court. That'll be the second one on him. Rochester will have the ball now with the clock showing 2:19 to play. Last year, Rochester was 17-5 and lost to Plymouth in the sectional. They moved up from 2A to 3A last year. John, picked up a little heavier schedule out there.
Yeah, Rochester is one of the smallest 3A schools there are, and here they are in the state championship game.
And they may be in a little bit of trouble as they get the bucket from Trevor George, giving him 6 in the quarter and 16 of the night. And that's the biggest lead for Princeton so far at 5. Trying to knock down 3 of them, can't get it done. Rebound taken out of there by Dontre Chavis, who averages 5 boards per game. They've got numbers at the other end and an offensive foul. Basket won't count. Foul is going to be against Jordan Simmons. The crowd doesn't know it yet, but that's going to be the call.
That's a great play by Grimm. He's in some foul trouble. Let's watch the action here. Here's the pass. This is the charge right there. He knew he was in some foul trouble, but decided to take that charge because his team needed it, and it played out well. Rochester down 5.
Full timeout with a minute 48 to play now. Fourth quarter of activity here at Conseco Fieldhouse. 3A championship of the 99th edition of the IHSAA Boys Basketball Tournament. Princeton leads by 5. Rochester will have the basketball. They've been outscored, John, in this quarter 10-2. Bruce Grimm has the only 2 points on a field goal in this fourth quarter for Rochester.
And they only have 10 points in the whole half. They had 37 at the halftime. Now they have 47. And on 4 of 22 shooting here in this second half.
Trap in the corner. They got 3. They got a wide open look over there, and they knocked it home. Good looking shot by Austin Lowe. His first field goal since the second quarter. A total of 5 points all. They get 6 points all together. And they're just getting bullied right now by the Chavis guys. Ron Trey with 20 points. Dontre now with his first field goal. 3 points for him. And it's a 54-50 game with a minute 10 to go.
Now Princeton back to man-to-man. Let's see if Rochester gets the good shots.
That's pretty good right there.
That was way out there. It's only a good shot that went in, and it did. His dad liked that one. Look at that.
4 3-pointers now for Bruce, giving him 62 on the year and 22 points on the game. That has tied the 3A record for threes made with 11 as a team. Plymouth had 11 against Washington back in 05. And a timeout, 30-second timeout. By Princeton.
Tom Weeks wanted that timeout to get his team set up. What a great shot by Bruce Grimm. 2 3-point shots in a row by Rochester has got him back in the game.
Well, the next game coming up should be a beauty likewise. A couple of teams that have not seen each other. John and I saw Bloomington South last Saturday. It's a very solid ball club. And Fort Wayne Snyder coming down from up north. They will bring themselves in here at 25-1 record. Bloomington South is 25-0. That's all coming up next on the Indiana Cable Network. John, would you concur that the turnaround of this game is laid mostly in the hands of the Princeton defensive adjustments?
Absolutely. The full court pressure and getting Rochester out of that comfortable offense from the first half, and then the rebounding of the Chavis brothers, too tough to stop inside. Look at how far out Bruce Grimm is as he takes this shot. But boy, did they need that. Dad's pretty happy about that shot going in right there.
Grimm was a transfer from Triton after the 05-06 season. He's headed to East Tennessee State. Baseline again, and once again, Chavis. Dontre. Dontre now with 4 points. His brother Rontre has 20, so between them, 24 points and probably close to 15 rebounds. And an outside three again by Bruce Grimm.
He just did that on his own on the dribble. This could come down to a last second shot, Jerry.
5-all game at 56. Third time it's been tied. They're going to go inside again. A near walking violation. They're going to count the basket. And the foul against Rochester. with 13 and a half seconds to go.
The inside game of Princeton's made the difference here in this second half. Pressure and taking the ball inside. And there's another example of it. Let's look at it inside. The long pass inside to Dontre Chavis takes it up strong. And look at the excitement. These kids are happy that that shot went in. They have the lead right now. Still a long way to go.
Dontre, a 54% free throw shooter, will be at the line trying to complete the three-point play. He's one out of two. He has 6 points in this quarter. But the real story in this quarter has been, for Rochester anyway, Bruce Grimm, who's hit back-to-back triples and has in the quarter 8 points and 25 of the game. Let's take a look again. Bruce Grimm hitting from outside. He now has 5 three-pointers.
Let's take a look. There he is, just behind that arc, off the dribble, going a little left, but gets that one to go. And then Princeton able to come down and get that shot on the inside. This free throw will be crucial. And just Dontre Chavis, 65% free throw shooter. So this is a big basket because it determines whether Rochester has to go for two or three as they get the ball down the floor.
You guys had the governor on earlier today. Little historical check. Rochester is the it's in Fulton County. That's the home of former Governor Otis Bowen. He was born in Fulton County. And a name I know, lads, that you know well, Elmo Lincoln.
Don't know that name, Jerry. That's a surprise.
You don't know the first ever Tarzan?
Did not know that,
he
Jerry.
He was born in 1918 in Rochester.
There you go.
See, it's just like a history lesson.
You are something. You are something. Well, history's about to be made because one of these teams is going to win the state championship, and we're not sure who it's going to be yet.
I mentioned a while ago that Grimm is going to East Tennessee State. And every time I say that, I think of that the young man for Washington a couple of years ago, Seth Coy.
And he's just finished his freshman year at East Tennessee State for last year's state championship team.
When they were congratulating, I saw him on TV the other night, and they were congratulating him, and there he was.
All right, big free throw right here. Dontre Chavis, 54%. His brother Rontre, 65. So only a 54% free throw shooter. Now another timeout by Rochester. Stretch this game out a little farther.
Rochester coming in here, as we mentioned, with the 23-3 record. Shane, a football two-year starter quarterback, all conference last year, plays baseball. Here's the game reset. Here's your timeouts, fouls, and possessions. Interesting. I have not seen the shirt, but they're wearing semi-state championship T-shirts, lads. It says, "Our coach teaches history. Our team makes history."
There you go.
That's kind of cool.
That's exactly right.
Rob Malko, the head coach at Rochester. Tom Weeks, graduate of Salem High School and William Penn University. His first sectional championship experience since he was a senior player at Salem in 85. And his last pointed out, writing a book about the Civil War. Here's Dontre, a big free throw. Got it. He's got a nice fourth quarter going, job with 7 points.
All right, that means that Rochester needs a three-point shot to tie this game, to send it in overtime. Full court pressure by Princeton.
Well, Grimm is the guy you would think they would go to. He has 5 so far in the game. We'll get a foul right at the midcourt stripe with 11-7 to play.
And that will be a 1-1 for Grimm. And not much time went off that clock. And Rochester has a chance then to make the steal or and foul right away if they don't steal and put Princeton back at the line. Grimm 77% from the line.
And they'll bring Dontre back onto the floor. He was out momentarily. Brant George will head to the sideline, and here comes Bruce Grimm. 2 out of 2 from the line so far tonight. 77% shooter for the 1-1. Kid's a nice player, Les.
Yeah, looks really good.
26 points, 9 in the quarter. As we pointed out, 5 three-pointers in the game. 63 on the year. You nail both of them. Now what do? You go with the foul?
Go for the steal and then the foul right away.
Princeton doing a good job of playing keep away. Here is that foul. And right in front of us, the foul is going to be on Brody Shane. That'll be 3 on the 6-foot senior.
But it's a 1-1, and so it's a 1-point game. We'll see how these free throws play out, and then the Rochester can decide how they want to handle it. They got the block out, though. Just saw Coach Malko on the sideline block these guys out. We don't want to give up an offensive rebound on a free throw.
Trevor George to the line. He's been perfect tonight, 5 out of 5. His percentage is only 55%, but you would never know it by the shooting style.
He looked real calm right there.
17 for Trevor. Other substitution now. Mark Bauer is coming back onto the floor. Rochester going to be down by 3 if he makes this, and they'll have to go again for the 3-point field goal. I guess if I'm Princeton, I'm going to foul. Last team to win an undefeated state championship, Lawrence North in 06. Just over the edge of the rim. 8 points in the quarter, 18 in the night. Here comes Rochester. They'll fake the 3. That's going to be a foul and a 3-point shot. Well, wait a minute. Nope, they're going to be kicking the ball. Well, that's a break for Princeton there, John.
Yeah, kicking the ball. That's a good call. And watch it now. Here's the play. Shot fake. Right there's the kick. The ball got loose, and Grimm was ready to go up for the winning 3-point shot or tying shot. But now we get out of bounds. 3.2 seconds to go.
Well, it's a big break for Princeton, because had that been a foul, it would have been a 3-shot foul. And you send Grimm to the line. But not the case. So let's set it for you, John. Let's replay it here. After the first quarter, Rochester led by 5, 25-20 in a wild and woolly first 8 minutes. Halftime, they were still up 37-29. Third quarter, Princeton did a terrific job of getting back into the game. They trailed by only 3, 45-42. Finally tied the game in that third quarter at 42. Then tied again at 56, and we're down to the final 3.2 at a 61-58 game in favor of Princeton. It'll be Rochester basketball.
Well, they need to set up a play right here quickly. 3 seconds, enough time to get the pass in, take a couple dribbles, and then even a shot then, or if you get double teamed, pass it to an open teammate. But they definitely need 3 points here to send this game into overtime.
Coming up next, Snyder of Fort Wayne High School, a record of 25-1, one of the top 10 teams of the state, will take on the number 1 team of the state, Bloomington South, J.R. Holmes Ball Club, undefeated in 25 games this year. Right after this game, we'll have the presentation of the Philadelphia Medal Attitude Award, and then the passing out of the trophies. Hopefully John will get a chance to chat with perhaps the winning coach and Medal Attitude Award winner. Here we go. Here's the game reset. No more timeouts for Rochester, so the pressure by Princeton going to force them to take the ball inbounds whether they want to or not. Set up in a high triple.
Watch for a screen to try to get Grimm open, then it'll be up to him to make the big decision.
He will have Jordan Simmons all over him. He does get free, gets down to the corner, gets the shot away. Hit it! Oh, my goodness, John!
I'll tell you, Jerry, that was tough. He went to his left. He faked to the right. And it's much tougher to hit that shot when you're a right-handed player going to your left. And it was meant to be. He sends this game in overtime. Look at it. Now he's saying, let's go, guys. We got the 4 minutes more to play. Here it is.
John, they got him stopped right here.
Four guys around him, and he hits that shot
with literally no time left on the clock.
Does that remind you of Scott Skiles from Plymouth, who hit a shot to win it?
It does. A break, then OT at Conseco, locked at 61. John, this thing's worth taking one more look at. What's the defense by Princeton? You can't fault him there.
They got four guys around him. He just makes a great shot. The clock runs out. Look at him. He knew that was going in. Fellas, we got 4 more minutes to play.
That ties the record for threes in a 3A final game with a half a dozen. Bruce Grimm Jr. averaging 25-2, now with 30 points as we go to overtime. Princeton will get the ball first on offense. Possession arrow into the hands of Rochester at the moment, of course. Final 4 minutes of overtime. May I say final? Who knows the way this thing's going?
Excellent ball game. Lots of fun in this 3A game.
Inside all alone and forcing the shot up and missing in close. Jalen Packer. Rebound comes off for Rochester, and Bruce Grimm's got it. And why not? He's done everything else tonight. Up the right sideline now to Brody Shane. Penetration inside, and that time Evan Hoff turned down what could have been a shot. Numbers on the break for Princeton. Layup there.
Good job by Graham. He got out of the way. Princeton on the fast break takes that ball strong to the hoop. Just what they need to do.
Lontre Chavis now with 22. 2-point lead for Princeton. There in the white uniforms, in the gold and black, Rochester. Here's a three from, oh my goodness, from Monument Circle.
Now he's got the record, that's 7, just like the other one he made in the first half, Joe, way outside.
That is his 4th in literally the 4th, well, his 5th in the second half. Right up front, shot does roll. Trevor George, he's had a nice game likewise. 20 points down for Trevor in this game. And a ball game at 65-64. All along, somebody missed a defensive assignment, and Brody Shane takes it all the way to the hoop, and that's the first field goal by Shane in the second half.
And he's just trying to break the press and then realize there was nobody between him and the basket. Made the right play.
Wide open look for three from the corner. Jalen Packer. Packer. 8 points, and lads, this is reminiscent of the first quarter of the game.
They're going right at it, offense to offense.
2-point lead now for Princeton. Knocked out of bounds in front of us here. Last touch by the Tigers.
Now Rochester's figured out this defense a little better, getting the shots that they want.
Colt Meadows coming into the ball game. Now let's take a look at this last 3-point field goal.
Wide open. Packer hits it from the left side.
That is 7 threes. That is the new record all time in all 4 classifications for Bruce Grimm Jr. Inside Grimm again.
Yeah, he's on a roll now. 35 points given for the ball game.
35 points. The record is Tyler Zeller's 42, if you're wondering. And there's a shot for the left wing that's good by Jordan Simmons.
That's a 2. Boy, Princeton is really hot too. They're hitting the outside shot when they went inside a lot in the second half.
10 points now for Jordan Simmons on the night. Rochester. This is the kind of the club that we saw in the first quarter. They were moving the ball well, getting their shots, hitting off balance. A minute 25 to go in OT. 70-68 Princeton. Here's the drive and the reach-in foul. Colt Meadows had a little bit of an alley. Started to make the move, and the foul's going to be tagged on to Lontre Chavis. It'll be 3 on him. Here's the record-setting 3-point field goal by Bruce Grimm.
Look at him. He looks like he's too far out, and that's why Packer wasn't on him, and Grimm able to hit that. Colt Meadows, 70% free throw shooter on the year.
Meadows, first free throw. In fact, that's his first point contribution since the opening quarter when he knocked down 1 of the 7 three-pointers in that quarter. Meadows looking to tie the game.
Pretty calm right there.
Top of your screen, the time left in OT. A minute 17 to play in overtime. Tie ball game at 70. Nice, beautiful fake off the mark. Good rebound that time by Mark Bowers. He averages only 4 per game, and here's a reach-in foul, and they may have Dontre Chavis. If they do, that'll be his 3rd.
Oh, a tough play for Princeton. They got the ball down low right where they wanted. The layup wouldn't go. And then the undersized Rochester team able to get that rebound. Now a foul. And it's been a long time since Rochester's had the lead. They did lead very early in this overtime, but
Lontre Chavis with his 4th foul, and that'll send Bowers to the line. Mark is a junior at 6'3", averages 4.8 points. He has 7. And he has scored 3 of the 7 here in the second half.
73% on the year. So Rochester's got some great shooters that have come through in a crucial situation from that line.
As a team, they shoot 73%. That's very acceptable. Bowers with another important free throw. Both look good. 9 points down for Mark. It's pretty much double his scoring average. Overtime with a minute 3 to play, and 72-70 Rochester. Princeton looking to go inside. They'd love to get the ball to Lontre Chavis, but Chavis has at least 2 guys on him wherever he goes. And a foul call on Bruce Grimm.
He's trying to apply the pressure so that it's hard to make that pass inside. got a little too close. Now that's his fourth foul, so he really has to be careful. Look at this, good defense. Double low post right there, and Grimm makes the foul.
Packer is at the line, the 6'2 sophomore. First time he's been at the free throw line. Had a big three in overtime to start things off. Well, John, we talked about free throw shooting, and Princeton's only a 60% shooting team as a team.
And Packer himself 60%. Rochester's made them all, and that was a miss by Princeton. Some substitutions now. So now it looks like Rochester may have the lead and the possession of the ball with 50 seconds. They'll try to keep possession and wait for that foul to come.
Oh, the rebound on the putback is good. Somehow, Dontre snuck inside after the mid-second free throw and picks up his first 2 points at OT, and we're tied again at 72.
Oh, inside rebounding, that's the key right there for Princeton.
32 seconds to play, overtime.
Rochester would soon hold this ball till the last second shot, if they can.
And they'll take a timeout. 22.8 remain. No shot clock, of course, on high school basketball, so Rochester can take their good sweet time and go for the victory. Let's take a look at the free throw that was missed, the second of the two by Jalen Packer, but a terrific effort by Dontre.
He just pushed his way right in there and got the ball. The Rochester player was in position, but he used that strength, his lower legs, and just pushed his defender out of the way and got the rebound.
Early on in the telecast, John, we talked about the fact that basically the Princeton Tigers have six starters. Dontre, the brother Durantre, both 6'4 sophomores, does not start, but he averages 11.5 points and 5 rebounds. He had been very quiet, only 1 point through three quarters. He had 7 points in the fourth quarter, has a bucket, that big one, in the overtime period. So he has come off the bench and provided some spark.
Absolutely, and it's been a great team effort by both teams. Princeton pounding that ball inside, hitting the offensive boards, and Rochester making some good outside shots and making their free throws. And we'll see if they can pull this off with a last second shot to win the state championship.
Oh my. If you're just joining us anticipating the start of the 4A championship, we had a game that literally was over, and Bruce Grimm had a three-pointer with at least three guys all over him. His third three-pointer in the fourth quarter to tie the ball game at 61 and send it to overtime. We are guessing, and I say guessing because both Terry Moore and I have lost track of the lead changes. We think we've had 16 lead changes last. Last look I had was 10, and it's up to 16 right now.
Now it's and the most important one is the one at the end of the game. Who's ever leading that one?
You got it. Six ties. Now what do you do, John? You got 22.8. Still going to use up the clock?
Absolutely. You're going to get the ball into your best shooter.
Right there he is.
Until he gets trapped and has to give it up, and then see if you can create a wide open shot. Not necessarily from Grimm, but a good shot, and the worst you want to do is go to a second overtime.
Grant George defending him. They throw it right into that free throw line area and bring it right back out inside 10 seconds. Here's the guy. This is Grimm. Grimm one-on-one now with Keenan Johnson. Here's the shot. Long, short, rebound taken off by Princeton. Second overtime coming up. Both ball clubs scored 11 points in the OT. Well, that in of itself, John's a little unusual. A lot of scoring in overtime.
It was a lot of scoring, and that's the way these kids like to play. It was a good shot by Grimm. Just hit the front of the rim, but he did the right thing. Took the shot with not enough time for Princeton to get one away. High rebound. Princeton's got it. No foul, of course. And we're going for 4 more minutes.
Well, we'll work a little harder tonight. Second overtime coming up. Princeton, Rochester, 3A title up for grabs. As you rejoin us here at Conseco Fieldhouse, the tip for the fourth quarter, for the second overtime, is controlled as it was in the first overtime by Princeton. 4 minutes to go in the second overtime session. Basket is going to count, I think, yes, on a foul call against Rochester.
Boy, the Chavis brothers are just too tough to stop. They take the ball to the hoop strong. It doesn't matter which one's shooting, the other one's rebounding. And following that back up, Rontre and Dontre Chavis controlling this game for Princeton on the inside.
That foul is on Colt Meadows. That'll be three on him. And they convert the three-point play. Rontre Chavis does. He had 2 points in the first overtime. Now give him three here in the second overtime. And a three-point lead at 75-72. Rochester really picked up the pace. Here's the floater right out front by Bruce Grimm. He has simply been phenomenal. He had 5 points in the first overtime session, John, and now gets his first two here in the second overtime.
Well, nice move to the right. You can see he can score off the dribble as well as the wide open shot.
I have him unofficially now for 36 points. Here he comes again off in the corner. He'll bring it back out again. Boy, they're looking for Grimm at every opportunity, averaging 25-2. Here he is again, this time off back iron. Nice rebound by Mark Bowers. Meadows stopping, looking for help on the right wing with 2:45 to play.
Smart play. Control the ball is important, making sure you get that good shot, even though they're down 1 point. And make a good shot every time.
Rebound snared off inside. Trevor George. His average per game is 8.1. Now we're down to 2.5 to go in the second overtime. I got a feeling even the Snyder and the Bloomington South fans are going to be enjoying this.
Absolutely.
Let's see what Princeton opts to do. They'd like to get inside and they'll get the bucket. And Dontre Chavis, again, I reiterate, this is a young man that does not start and was very quiet through the first three quarters, but he has played well in the fourth quarter and the first two overtimes here. All of a sudden, we got ourselves a three-point ball game again, 77-74. All the way in, here's the scoop shot, yes, Austin Lowe.
With a London play now, players trying to take charges, but no calls being made.
Lowe with eight, his first point since the fourth quarter. A minute 40 to play. 77-76, Princeton with the lead in the basketball. Wide open look outside. Long rebound taken off of the far side by Simmons. But back up and good.
Offensive rebound. It's been their best offense when they missed their first shot. Princeton on the boards.
12 points now for Simmons, averaging just under 9 per. A minute 11 to play. Overtime number two, again a three-point ball game. Pull up Grimm, got it again. Oh, what a show this kid's putting up. I mean, what a show.
He got a screen and nobody there to help. He was going to his left again, but wide open when he came across that screen for that shot. Tie game.
Tie ball game at 79. It's the ninth time it's been tied. That's the 8th three-pointer for Bruce Grimm in this game, Laz.
Yeah, he's got 38 points here on the scores board. But now the exact opposite from the first overtime. Princeton has the ball with a chance to take a last-second shot. And how important will an offensive rebound be at this point if the first shot doesn't go?
On the far sideline, the Princeton coach, Tom Weeks. You can see him there.
Talking to his players, they've got his attention, and he's called a play out. We'll see what it is.
Well, this could be your Class 3A championship where we go to another overtime. Here's the three, off the mark, rebound put up, and off the mark, and a foul is called with 2.9. And once again, the big body of Dontre Chavis.
Just we expected, the offensive rebound has been the play. It's brought Princeton back here in this second half. Watch. Rochester trying to block out, but Dontre is just too big and strong, and that ball's coming off. He's able to go after it. And some big free throws right here.
He's 2 out of 3 from the line tonight. John mentioned earlier, 54% free throw shooter. He'll get two. Looking for his first free throws in overtime. That's a big one right there. Substitutions now for the Zebras. Evan Hoff coming back onto the floor. Jason Smith coming out there for Rochester. Just a remarkable game by Bruce Grimm. 5 points in the first overtime. 5 more here in the second overtime. Second free throw is good. And we'll get a timeout by Rochester. Well, we've been down this road before, John.
Last year, the 4A championship game, Jerry, I'll never forget it. Brownsburg wins it with a long court, full court pass, and a shot at the buzzer.
Well, let's kind of recap things for you here in the overtime session. This is the guy, John, that's made the noise, Dontre Chavis. I said earlier how short he was. I had the wrong figures in front of me. Both he and Rontre are 6'4". Rontre carried the ball club through three quarters, and he's done a nice job in the fourth quarter in the two OTs.
That twisting layup by Austin Lowe was absolutely terrific. And Princeton just keeps attacking the basket. And Rochester gets a lot of their points from the outside, especially Grimm having a great night. 40 points now for Grimm in this ball game.
I'm not sure that Bruce Grimm knows where the 3-point line is, because he's about 4 or 5 feet behind it on several occasions. Now what do you do? John, gonna go to him again? You don't need the three right now, though.
You've got to set up a play. You need 2 points, but the clock is what's against you, just 2.9. You've got to bring it the full length of the court, so you need a long pass, or at least a pass where your offensive player is moving down the floor towards your basket. You get a couple dribbles and a shot, or one dribble, a pass and a shot. Maybe try what Brownsburg did. Take that long pass, although it's not a big team. You know, Princeton has the size advantage to steal that long pass. So a couple different options for Coach Rob Malkow. But I bet that Bruce Grimm's going to get the ball somehow and try to let him win this game or send it overtime again.
Well, both clubs have 10 personal fouls, so we're in that double bonus situation. The individual scoring record for Class 3A, 43 points set by Tyler Zutter of Washington High against Harding. That was a year ago. Now here's the scenario. You got to go the full 90 plus feet. You got to do it in 2.9. Got to get a shot away. Here's the baseball pass, intercepted. And a foul. Nope, they did not commit the foul. The interception on the baseball pass, and Princeton has come away with a double overtime win, 81-79. They set it up to go at least to midcourt, and a step-in interception gives the Princeton Tigers their first state championship in any sport. What a game. What a game. Well, coming up next will be the presentation of the Arthur L. Krester Mental Attitude Award, presented by our friends at Farm Bureau Insurance. We'll have a member of the IHSA Executive Committee out to make the announcement, then representative from Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, one of our sponsors, and we thank them for their participation. A lot of milling around on the floor right now as the Princeton Tigers celebrate. There is their head coach, Tom Weeks. He's writing a book on the Civil War. Well, he's writing a book about winning a championship right now. John Laskowski is headed in that general direction. We'll try to get a comment from Tom. We'll try to get a comment likewise from the Mental Attitude Award winner. And what a terrific game. A double overtime win for the Princeton Tigers. And they will become, as I mentioned, the 11th undefeated state champion. The first was back in 56, Chris Posadic's Tigers. Then South Bend Central, Indianapolis, Washington, East Chicago, Roosevelt, East Chicago, Washington, and then Marion. Those were all single class undefeated champions. In the classifications, the first overtime, first undefeated team, 2003, when Pike and Cass, Pike in 4A, Cass in 2A, both went undefeated and won titles. Class A Waldman in 04 and 4A Lawrence North in 06, and now add the Princeton Tigers to that list. Let's go across the floor now and pick up Scott Gray.
In Class 3A basketball, making the presentation of the Arthur L. Krester Award for Mental Attitude will be Deb Stevens of Caston, a member of the IHSA Executive Committee.
We would like to first welcome Mr. Matt Hayes, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance Agent from Indianapolis, to assist with the presentation of the 2009 Arthur L. Krester Mental Attitude Award for Class 3A Boys Basketball. A mental attitude award is presented in each of the 20 IHSA sports. This award is based on scholarship, mental attitude, leadership, and athletic ability. In addition to the award, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, a proud corporate sponsor of the IHSA, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Since 1989, over 629,000 in college scholarships have been presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance to deserving high school students in our state. On behalf of the IHSAA, please join us in saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for its generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the IHSA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2009 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class 3A Boys Basketball is Brody Shane of Rochester.
That's Brody Shane, ranked fifth in his class of 125 at Rochester High. He's going to graduate with honors. He's going to attend DePaul University over in Greencastle, studying business and math. He is the son of Bobby and Lori Shane of Rochester. Let's go back out and pick up Scott.
$1,000 to Rochester High School. This money will be added to the general scholarship fund in the name of Brody Shane. Thank you again to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, and congratulations to Brody and Rochester High School.
Well, our congratulations going to Brody Shane. I'm sure he'd rather have the championship trophy, but that's a nice reward likewise. We're back now at Conseco Fieldhouse, and John Laskowski has the proud parents of our Mental Attitude Award winner. John?
They wish the game would have turned out differently, but congratulations. Quite an honor for your son. Tell us a little about him.
He's been a very good student. He's the quarterback on the football team, basketball, and then plays baseball. He played golf for 2 years and then switched to baseball.
I know you're very
proud of him.
You've got to be very proud of him. Talk about his future plans. What does he want to do in college?
Well, hopefully he plans on going to DePaul, and he's looking at football and majoring in business and math. So the university is looking forward to having him next fall.
You made a great comment. You wish the game would end at 72-72, right?
Yeah, I don't know how that works. I think it should end at a tie, and that way there couldn't be any losers, but somebody has to come out on the losing end, and we just happen to be the team, I guess.
Congratulations. Great honor for your son.
Thank you so much.
All right, Jerry, back to you.
Nice parents, Bobby and Lori Shane of Rochester, and their son, Brody, picking up the IHSAA Executive Committee's nominee of the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Awards. Line of break. Back with more activity here at Conseco Fieldhouse. There's your score. Princeton, your champion. Well, there's the final score of 81-79 in favor of Princeton in double overtime. Your state champions. Championship medals being handed out. Head coach of the Princeton Tigers. Oh, what a game this was. Neither club could shake the other. 16 lead changes, 9 ties. Biggest lead of the night, Rochester was up by 9 in the second half. Big lead for Princeton was 5 in the ball game, so neither club could get it in double digits. And we'll come back and signify the MVP. Joyce in this game, and almost everybody qualifies for that honor. 2-point win for the Tigers. Right, we're back just in time to see the presentation of the championship trophy. Won't that look good in the trophy case at Princeton High School? Their first ever state championship in any sport. And on the other side of the issue, Rochester picking up It's first, it's fourth, check it, make it the sixth Mental Attitude Award. This time the honor going to Brody Shane. Well, let's take a look now at tonight's MVP, sponsored by triptocollege.org. Make your play to higher education at triptocollege.org. It's a great way to get going. Interestingly enough, our choice is going to be one of the Chavis brothers, but not the one that started. We're going to go with 42, Dontre Chavis, because after being shut out in the first half, and we told you he's like a sixth starter, comes off the bench and averages 11 and a half points and 5 rebounds, had nothing in the first half, only 1 point on a free throw, of course, in the third quarter. Then in the fourth quarter came up with 7 points. In the first overtime had a field goal. In the second overtime, 4 points and a field goal and 2 important free throws. Finishes his game with 14 points on 5 of 10 shooting, 4 out of 5 from the line, 4 rebounds, 3 of those off the offensive glass, by the way. And so Dontre Chavis is our most valuable player, sponsored by triptocollege.org, and our congrats to him and the rest of the Princeton Tigers. Laz still out on the court. We'll come back and get some more info for you. There's your final score in double overtime. Princeton wins the 3A championship. Well, the official team photo being taken now by the various members of the media who've come in from all around the state. And what a game it was. Time now for the Comcast high-speed play of the game. Comcast always dreaming, never stopping. Well, just when we thought the game was going to be over, keep an eye on number 4, Bruce Grimm. Literally 2 seconds to go, he fires. You can see the scoreboard at the top of the screen. With 2 seconds to go, he hits one at the buzzer to send the game into overtime. Grimm with a terrific game, finishes up with 40 points. He had 14 of 29 from the floor, 8 of 15 from the three-point area, hit all 4 of his free throws, had 4 rebounds and 3 assists. But that was the Comcast high-speed play of the game. Comcast always dreaming, never stopping. Sent it into overtime, and then in overtime he was also effective with 5 points in the first OT, 5 more in the second OT, and Bruce Grimm Jr., 6'1 senior, with a total of 40. I have a chance, hopefully, now to get a little chat with the winning head coach here of the Princeton Tigers, Tom Weeks. He's heading over toward John Laskowski as we speak. Understandably, a lot of congratulatory hands being stuck out in his direction. Las?
Coach Tom Weeks, what a great game that was. Something you'll remember forever.
Well, I don't know how you could forget it. What a thing to be a part of. They call those instant classics anymore, and I think it was. Tremendous job by Bruce Grimm and all of Rochester. Tremendous game. I thought our kids did a tremendous job of doing what we wanted to do. Hey, what a ball game.
It was a great first half offensively for Rochester. You made some great changes at the half, putting more pressure on them full and half court.
Well, we did. I didn't think our defensive intensity was there, and I didn't think our rebounding. I thought they beat us to loose balls and the rebounds. I thought we did a better job of it the second half, limited their ability to get loose balls and some cheap buckets, and then did a great job on the offensive glass, which we know we're strong.
That made the difference. It looked like Rochester would give you that three-point shot. Your guys didn't take it, but offensive rebounding won the game.
Oh, it did, and our guys shoot them, but we've scored, you know, a lot of points without having to take them, and we continued to put it inside and got it to guys, and they did a good job.
Coach, congratulations. Great
Thank
job.
You all.
All right, Jerry, back to you.
Thank you, Laz. Back in 65, they lost to Indianapolis, Washington in the afternoon semifinal game. In 83, they lost to Connersville in the afternoon semifinal game. Tonight, they're the winners. Bacon Laz now back at Contigo. Just a quick look at the numbers on the screen. But, John, something that got my attention down at the bottom of our stat page. The points in the paint, 44-12 in favor of Princeton in that game.
Contrasting styles by both teams, but 44 points in the paint for Princeton offsets the 15 of 33 from three-point land that Rochester hit.
Individual scoring, Rochester led by the sensational performance of Bruce Grimm. He had 40 points in the game, including a record-setting 8 three-pointers. Princeton led by the 25 points of Dontre Chavis, 20 points of Trevor George, 14 from Dontre Chavis, and a dozen from Jordan Simmons. In double overtime, Princeton becomes the 3A champions with a win of 81-79.